Thank you, person in the back. All right. So, taking a look at traditional versus online, I can tell you right now, for if you start independent, your sales online are going to dwarf your paper sales by a factor of 10. That is on average. For every physical book you sell, you will sell 10 online copies. So keep that in mind as you think about committing to print. Print's wonderful. It's great to have printed copies. We have printed copies. We give them out. We sell them. We've got them in libraries. But I can tell you, just looking at the sales numbers, people want digital. It's cheaper. It's easier. It's quick to download. And there's so many mediums out there for it.
And there's a lot of marketing opportunities for e-books versus traditional. I get a thing every day in my email box from BookBub that's like, hey, this book is 99 cents. Guess how many e-books I buy now? A lot.
Gee, that sounds like you shop the same place I do.
Right, so we're going to use these two. So let's say that you want to self-publish that book. Looking at it, self-publishing is a great, cheap, and easy way to get your story out there. The problem is the perceived level of professionalism behind your work. If your cover does not look professional, people may not buy your book. Horrible as that sounds, it's true. We do buy a book based on its cover.
People do judge books based on covers. I've also been guilty of this.
Yes. If the formatting's not right in your book for whatever reason, something that a traditional publishing house would take care of, people might not buy it. Publishing houses are great because they'll set you up at conventions, they'll set you up at tables, they'll set you up at libraries and signings and stores. That's really cool to have somebody handle all that marketing and publishing and distribution. On the flip side, you're going to make more money, believe it or not, doing it independently. You really will. You look at a lot of starter contracts from publishers. You look at how much they're willing to pay you, and it sounds really good. They might say, for instance, we'll give you $50,000 if you give us a book in the next 2 years. Like, oh my God, $50,000 for a book, woo! But think about what you really just agreed to. 2 years, $25,000 a year. You're being paid a $25,000 a year job to write, rewrite, and edit that book nonstop. You can make more money either flipping burgers or teaching English in an elementary school than you can writing in that book. It's not as much money as it sounds like. And a lot of them won't even give you the big magic of $50,000. Chop a zero or two off of that. Most traditional publishing houses start you at $1,000 now because you're at risk. People don't buy print as much as they used to. In short, you'll make some money, but if you're looking for a high return right up front, independent is actually the better way to go. Working with companies. Amazon is a very flexible company when you're starting out. So is Nook. So is Books a Million. There are tons of companies out there that will give you templates, layouts, examples, tutorials, YouTube, anything you can think of to help you get your story out there. It doesn't hurt to work with companies. It doesn't hurt to look at a tutorial. Anyway, we already discussed this. Look at the upfront that you'll get versus the long-term return on investment. We started independent. We got offered publishing contracts after the fact. I sat down and I did the math. I kid you not, we were making more money doing this independently than we were based on a traditional publishing contract. How many of you have ever heard of Shawn McGuire? She is awesome.
You guys need to hear about her. She's great.
Yep. She's got multiple series published out there. She puts out about 3 books a year. She is incredible. She's extremely popular. Does cons all over the world, and she makes enough to support herself.
And her mom.
And her mom.
And her cats.
Yes, her cats.
But the point is, she's not a millionaire. She's a working girl. She makes as much as you would at a traditional job. And she did it. She is out there selling literally millions of copies of her book. But I mean, there's a reason you know names like Stephen King and George R.R. Martin. It's because there's only a couple folks like Stephen King and George R.R. Martin. And when you do this, you're not going to be a millionaire overnight.
Yeah. Has anyone heard of Cameron Hurley? She's got 3 series out there and published. She's been Hugo nominated. She has a day job.
Yeah.
She makes more of her day job writing ad copy for companies than she does with her published fiction and nonfiction.
There's a reason that this is our second job, or third job, depending on which one this is. rather than our primary method of income.
My wife is a published author. My wife has over 100 works out. She does ghostwriting, she does ad copy, she does transcription work, advertisements, all sorts of different things. And the thing that she makes the absolute least amount of money on is fiction writing. That's become the passion project. The stuff that pays the bills is the grunt work.